Meantime, we've been following this, and westbound I-80 still shut down following that fiery big rig crash in the Sierra.
And KCR3's Mike Tissell joining us now live along I-80. And Mike, it sounds like it's going to take a while to get this thing figured out and cleaned up.
Yeah, it took us a while just to go back upstream through all of the backed up traffic, get off the freeway and make our way down to Colfax. We made our way down here because we want to bring you some of the eyewitness accounts of what happened here. Take a look at some of the video. Again, what happened is a big rig, according to the CHP, jackknifed in driving too fast in wet conditions. A second big rig following that one could not avoid it in time. They both slammed into each other, both touching off a fiery mess in the Sierra. I talked to one of those big rig drivers, the one who was trailing. He explained what happened and how lucky they both are to be alive. Listen.
That guy, he jackknifed his truck, and I was back there when I seen the truck step on the brakes, couldn't stop it, and just went on through that side.
Now, that was Juan Mercado. He was the one who was driving the hay truck. He was headed to Tulare today. He says, when I asked him, how lucky are you given how these trucks burst into flames? He said, we are both extremely lucky. He said, especially the guy in the jackknife truck, because that is the truck where his trailer slammed into the cab of that truck. He says that man, in his words, was reborn today because he is lucky to be alive. I also talked to several other truckers who were trailing this and witnessed the accident as it was happened. One guy said it was the worst thing he'd ever seen because it looked like two homes that were on fire. He also said that he nearly collided with those big rigs as well because of the slick roadway. He too had trouble stopping. And again, as Kristen Marshall has mentioned throughout the morning, this also sparked several other collisions uphill of where this was. All of that right now is what emergency crews are dealing with. And as you heard the update, this is something that may not be cleared until the noon hour. I can tell you just from coming from there, they got a lot to clean up before they can allow traffic to start making its way through there. Live in Colfax, stay tuned. We'll have more reaction coming up. Mike Tissell, KCRA 3 reports.